Every day, 20 veterans commit suicide in the United States. That's according to the Department of Veterans Affairs.
A local nonprofit is putting that number into perspective. As Heidi Wigdahl found out, they hope it starts a larger conversation around military and veteran suicides.
You never know what someone else is going through, but at the state capitol, a local nonprofit wants to help others understand what it's like.
A lot of stories to these boots.
To stand in another's shoes.
The character. If you look at the boots here, they're none are the same. You know, they have blood, sweat, tears, oil, gas, mud on them. They have character. They're like fingerprints. They're fingerprints of a soldier.
According to the Department of Veterans Affairs, 20 veterans commit suicide every day. 20 lives lost, 20 boots added to the Capitol steps every day this week.
Yep. It's pretty sad. Yeah, it's hard to, and by Friday when you see the 100 pair of boots, that's only 5 days. You know, it's a huge visual representation of what's happening every single day.
Something that's too familiar to Captain Michael Langer.
I'm a 23-year veteran, and this is something that hits close to me. I've lost friends, family members, fellow soldiers to suicide. And so I'm an officer right now in the National Guard. And to me, it's not a story that's told enough.
Yesterday, we had a family come out and place their son's boots. He took his life in February.
David Peters is the director of Operation 23-0. Its mission, to raise awareness about military suicide.
And our second mission, if you will, is peer support, getting guys and girls together, you know, talking, hanging out, having a good time. And third and finally is resource connectivity.
Peters served 12 years in the U.S. Marine Corps, starting Operation 23-0 in 2015. Mm-hmm. While we hear a lot about PTSD, Peters says we're seeing more suicides that are non-combat related. A 2016 study of more than 163,000 men and women in the Army found that most soldiers who attempted suicide between 2004 and 2009 hadn't been deployed yet.
You know, I don't have all the answers. No one has all the answers. But the more people we can get thinking about it and talking about it, the better off it is for everyone.
It's their third year displaying boots at the Capitol. Boots that belong to people like Minnesota National Guard's Joel Costa, who committed suicide in February.
I think this year especially, we've had a large amount of people that have come up and approached us wondering what's going on and why we have this out here. And it is a good, you can talk numbers all day, but until you actually see it, it's tough for it to become real.
But if you're having trouble, you can call me and vice versa.
A conversation on the Capitol steps.
It's traumatic, and it there are brothers and sisters, and it shouldn't happen. I mean, there's help out there. The numbers shouldn't be this high.
So if you do want to check it out, it's every day 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. and that'll go on until Friday. And Friday is again where you're going to see those 100 pairs of boots to represent the 5 days.
Powerful.
Yeah, extremely powerful.
Yeah, that visual is something that you shouldn't just walk past. You need to really look at that and imagine. That's the reality.
And it's just so hard to think that these our brothers and sisters and sons and daughters are going off, they're surviving in a war zone, and then they're coming home and taking their own lives. We've got to figure out how to fix that.
Right, and I do have on care11.com, we have a list of resources, some local ones through that nonprofit that people can look at too if they need some help.
Awesome.
Thank you.
Thanks, Heidi.
Yeah.